40 years ago today, Sara Jane Moore aimed a gun at President Gerald Ford in San Francisco and fired a single bullet. The bullet missed Ford by inches. That attempt came just 17 days after another woman, a Charles Manson follower, tried to assassinate Ford. Sara Jane Moore received a life sentence for the attempted assassination, but she was released on parole in 2007, and Sara Jane Moore is now speaking out and joins us this morning. What drove you to want to try to assassinate President Ford?
Well, everybody asks that, and the thing is that everybody was talking about it. They say, where did you get the idea? I don't know about the rest of the country, but in San Francisco, people were saying this all the time. Number one, we elect our presidents, we don't appoint them. And Gerald Ford was appointed, and he was appointed by a crook, if you will pardon the expression. So it wasn't a unique feeling. It was partly that there were other people who had talked about it, who I thought were much more important to what we were thinking of as the revolution, and we really truly thought there was going to be one. And I thought somebody like me, I was a nobody, it would be better coming from somebody like me and not destroying these people who I felt were leaders. And if they did this, it would destroy their leadership.
So you missed, obviously. And how long after you fired that bullet did the sort of realization, the enormity of what you'd tried to do, dawn on you?
Oh, I think the enormity of it had dawned on me before. As I said in a letter that I wrote to President Ford later, that I think life was more important then than it is now. It was sort of an awesome decision to make a decision to take somebody's life. I don't think people feel like that now, but at the time it was. So the decision ahead of time, the thing that surprised me, and this probably sounds very silly, is I was concerned about the publicity, but only in the Bay Area. It never occurred to me that this was a story that was going to go all over the world.
Oh, my gosh. You served more than 30 years in prison. You got out in 2000.
More than 32 years.
More than 32 years. You got out of prison in 2007. You then were given 5 years of parole. Are you still on parole?
Yes, I am. The rules say that after 5 years of clear conduct, you're mandatory release. You're supposed to be released from parole. And I am now 7 years of clear conduct and have yet to be released from parole.
And why is that? I mean, I believe that you have gone on and proven as best you can to the court that you are now an upstanding citizen. You've turned over a new leaf. So what do they tell you?
Well, I was always a pretty good citizen. Let's not talk about turning over a new leaf. Nothing. The first time that they turned me down, I was shocked, because one would have thought the incident had happened the day before. The way they talked about me, and I was in total shock. And they repeated much the same this time. They're supposed to release you unless they feel that you're going to commit another offense. And I don't know what offense I would commit. Jaywalking, perhaps?
Well, I mean, there you have. I mean, I say you've turned over a new leaf, and you bristle at that, but you tried to kill the president of the United States back then.
Yes, but it makes it sound like I was a totally different person, and I was pretty much the person I am now, had gotten into something over my head, I will admit that, had quit listening to reason. So for a little while, I was a different person, but in terms of being your ordinary, normal citizen who gets up and goes to work and I think the only criminal I'd had before had I'd gotten a ticket for jaywalking.